Hello, people, and lots of doing, and welcome to another Battlemind. This time we are battling against the son of the game two between us two. Yes, that is right. This battle was recorded by Blaze Shadowthorn, whose channel I do recommend to check out. But without further ado, let's jump right into the team preview. So the first game ended up in my favor, so in a sense I can kinda ease up on the second game and kinda see what kind of strategy she's going to try to pull off to counter me on the second game. What kind of adjustments she's gonna do, all that. So what I'm gonna bring is Staraptor, Gothitelle, Ferrothorn, and a Blastoise. First thing off against her, her Talonflame, Azumarill, Raichu, and Charizard, which was proven to be Charizard Y in the battle before. So, looking at the team battle and the team preview, well, I don't think that I should be in too much trouble, but we will see, because we will jump right into the match, and Susanna is going to be doing a challenge against us, and she's going to leave out the Fragile and Azumarill, the Talonflame, and the Azumarill Blessing over against my Danielle and Vileplume lead once again. So I will get off that intimidated on both of these physical attackers, which is just great. And now I will make a safe move in my behalf. What I assume to be a taunt coming from the Talonflame, because I have seen Talonflame a couple of times and I don't want to face that. I bring in the ninja to take that taunt. The Talonflame goes with Brainbird onto my Danielle and just brings it down to 62 HP. And foolishly, I will go with Final Gambit onto that Azumarill slot, expecting a taunt coming from the Talonflame. So I wanted to blow that Azumarill out from the Citrus Berry range, but that is not the case, ladies and gentlemen. My Staraptor goes down without a fight. So now the Azumarill gets a Battle Drum up once again on the second match as well. Puts itself on plus 6, and now I am facing off with a Ferrothorn and a Azumarill with a full HP Ferrothorn versus a plus 6 Azumarill, which is not really what I want to deal with. So now I bring my Viviana onto this switching, and then the Charizard is gonna come in onto from the bringing back the Choice Band set Talonflame, showing me that it is indeed a Choice Band Talonflame. Blastoise is gonna go mega wrecked into its mega ring, and then it's time to unleash the one. Azumarill is gonna go with Protect, and then it's time for me to go with Protect on my Ferrothorn, anticipating a level is coming from that Talonflame, but that's not the case. And now I'm just gonna unleash the water spout, taking that Charizard out, and it is going down without a fight in this one as well. This time it wasn't locked into Jolo Beam, it was brought in to die. So now the boy Pia the Raichu is gonna come in, and then I'm gonna throw my Vivian, which, and into my Gothitelle, the Wild Chase. Wild Chase comes on out onto this turn. And Azumarill goes with Aqua Jet. Will the Wild Chase survive? No, it will not. As the critical hit does indeed hit on it, and it's just the end of this tie. That the Raichu is gonna go with Encore and just lock my Ferrothorn in. There isn't much else I can do about it, because if I go with Fake Out on Raichu, the Azumarill is gonna kill me. If I Fake Out the Azumarill, the Raichu is gonna use Thunderbolt on my Vivian. So that was a good game on my behalf, and game two kind of showed me one thing indeed. It didn't actually even show that much. It was kinda difficult game to play with, because I assumed that the Talonflame would have been taunt variant instead of choice band, but it's alright, I still have the third game to play for, so best of threes have that kind of a nifty thing in them. You don't have to, you know, always make the right play, so that's good. So on the top, there's the previous battle when I had Mr. Senna, and on the bottom, there's the most recent showdown live of mine, and thank you guys for watching, thank you guys for enduring my narration, and as always, leave a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe, and as always, have a fine day!